song. Though darkness fills the night, it cannot hide the light. Whom shall I fear? You crush the enemy underneath my feet. You are my sword and shield. Though troubles linger still, whom shall I fear? I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. My strength is in your name, for you alone can save. You will deliver me, yours is the victory. Whom shall I fear? Who stands behind? The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. And nothing formed against me shall stand. Who stands behind? The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The God of angel armies is always by my side.
Our text reading is found in Revelation 1, verse 4 to 7. John, to the seven churches which are in Asia, grace to you and peace from him who is and who was and who is to come and from the seven spirits who are before his thrones and from Jesus Christ, who faithful witnesses, the firstborn from the dead and the ruler over the kings of the earth, to him and loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood, and his has made us kings and priests to his God and Father. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming with clouds, and every eye will see him, even they who pierced him, and all the tribes of the earth will mourn because of him. Even so, amen.
Cannot resist that I cannot sing my daughter, so I want to sing. Even I get that practice.
Darkest day, Christ on the road to Calvary, tried by sinful men, torn and beaten, when nailed to the cross of wood. Is the power of the cross. Christ became sin for us, took the blame for the wrath we stand forgiven at the cross. Oh, to see the path written down your face, bearing the awesome weight of sin. Every evil deed, crowning your blood-stained brow, is the power of the cross. Christ became sin for us, took the blame for the wrath we stand forgiven at the cross. Oh, to see my name written in the wounds, for to your suffering I am free. Because that's to cry, life is mine to live, won through the selfless love. Is the power of the cross. Christ became sin for us, took the blame for the wrath we stand forgiven of. The power of the cross, Son of God, slain for us. What a love! at the cross we stand forgiven at the cross.
And I love that old cross. nearest and missed, for a word of lost sinner was slain. I believe in a hill called Mount Calvary. I believe whatever the cost, and in time I surrender, and earth is no more. I am still clinging to the old rugged cross.
I believe that the Christ who was slain hang on the cross has the power to change lives today.
Surely one day we'll come to an end. But faith will conquer the darkness and death, and will lead me at last to my friend.
So I'll cheer.
Unspeakable joy that makes my
Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone, and the new is here. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation, that God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as through God we're making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf. We reconciled to God. God made himself who had no sin but to be sin for us, so that in him who had no sin to be might become the righteousness of God.
Souls of all men made its way through the
the heart of Jerusalem. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love for you. Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary.
Down from his glory, ever living story, my God and a Savior came, and a Jesus was his name. Thank you.
Christ alone my hope is found. He is my life, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid rock, firm to the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here with the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the depths of Christ I lay. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground in sinking sand, all other ground in sinking sand. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of a man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or call me home, here in the power of Christ I stand. Our
verse for today is Romans chapter 8, verse 31 to 39. God's everlasting love. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but delivered him for us all. How shall we not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is who justifies. Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died and furthermore is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercessions for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or pearl, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death
nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be to separate us from the love of God which is in the Christ Jesus our Lord.
To live near, whose words alone can
hearts of fallen stars. Crucified, lay behind a stone. You lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall,
you took the fall,
and thought of me above all. Crucified, lay behind a stone. You lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall,
you took the fall,
and thought of me above all, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall,
you took the fall,
and thought of me
Beautiful singing, beautiful songs. Beautiful Jesus. Are you inspired today? Is your heart nicely warmed? Is your faith lifted? Well, that's what it's all about, eh? All of this is to lift our faith, make us strong in the Lord and His mighty power, and continue to rejoice, rejoice in His love and goodness. Many Adventists today are called sad Adventists. Sad Adventists. And it is my prayer that the joy of the Lord will be your strength and hope. Don't let this cool off. We're all on a high this Easter weekend. It's a great time to build our faith in the Lord. Amen. Now, the devil has a way of deflating us and pulling us down again. You know, like you have a mountaintop experience, then you've got to hit the valleys of life. The road of suffering, the road of struggle. And it's my prayer, beloved, that you will always behold Jesus on the cross. That we'll always focus on His great love for us. Amen? Go home rejoicing today. Go home praising the Lord. It doesn't stop here. Jesus rested in the tomb on the Sabbath. But something wonderful happened on the first day of the week. What happened? He rose again. Yes, He rose again for you and for me. He rose again so that He will be our life's companion. He rose again so He'll be a companion to help us carry the load and the burdens of life. He rose again so that we can find hope and eternal life with Him when He comes. So the resurrection is so special. What do you say today? Wonderful, the resurrection. Before I pray, let me just give you a small, what do you call this now? I just forget the word. I just lost my word. It's like an analogy, you know, but there's a word for that. Pardon? Donna says that sign of aging. You know. I can't argue with her. But in this analogy, pardon? In this analogy, there was a conversation between death and the grave. And so death said to grave on Friday, I hope you got him. I hope he is nice and secure. I hope you got the chains around him. We don't want him to escape. And so grave said, no problem, buddy. I got him. Everything's cool. You don't have to worry. That was on Friday when death made this phone call on Rogers Network. And then on Saturday, Sabbath morning, death makes another call to grave. And death says to grave, do you still have him? Is he still there? And grave said, of course I still have him. He's in the jaws of the grave. Nobody can take him away. Saturday night, they made another call from death. Do you still have him there? Of course I do. He's there. And early Sunday morning, just in case everything was okay, death made another call. Do you have him there, grave? And grave started trembling. He says, death, I don't know, but something's happening around here. The ground is shaking. Everything seems to be exploding around here. Oh, death, I don't know what's going on. And there was a cut in the call. There was such a huge earthquake, for the grave could not hold death. Jesus, the grave could not hold him. And he rose again in power and in glory. What do you say today? Go home rejoicing. Let's stand for prayer. Dear Father, thank you for the joy of salvation. Thank you for the assurance of the joy of the resurrection and the comfort that it brings to us, the hope that it brings to us, and the happiness that it brings to us. Thank you for taking all the nails, the thorns, the spear in your side. Thank you for taking the mockery, the derision, the insults. Thank you for taking the imprisonment. Thank you for dying for us. Oh, what a Savior. As we've heard all the beautiful songs that have glorified and honored you today, we love you and we worship you. And Lord, it's our privilege to be associated with you, with the great God of the universe. Would you bless us as we leave this church? As we go our separate ways to our homes, make our homes sweeter. Make our homes brighter. Make our hearts and lives sweeter and brighter. And give us the patience and the love. We thank you for the blood, the power of the blood of the Lamb. Thank you for being a Lamb for us. And so, Father, keep us strong and faithful. Help us with overcoming power to overcome the setbacks of life. Overcome the difficulties and the obstacles. And may we walk with the joy of the Lord. Dismiss us now with your richest blessings. Bless our leaders here, our church, our family, and all of those who participated and those who are here. May this be a great lift in our faith, to hold on to you, to anchor our faith in you. In Jesus' name I pray. Everybody said amen. God bless you all. Thank you so much. Thanks for all the lovely songs and singing. Bless you. Thank you, Sister Hope, for arranging things.